Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and Google was nice enough to contact me and send along a new Pixelbook Go a little bit early. So they sent along this package. I thought it was just going to be the Pixelbook itself, but we've got a little bit more here. Now I opened this and it was actually ripped already, but let's go ahead and open it up and we'll see what we've got here. So what we have is a Pixelbook Go user guide. We've also got a Pixelbook Go challenge. So we'll set these aside. They've sent along some accessories as well. So these are laptop carrying cases from, looks like from Bellroy, but it says made for Google inside. So that's pretty interesting. It's nicely padded. So I'll set that aside, really, really nice. And then we've got another one here. It says pull down to open, and it's a huge backpack. So it looks like we've got space for just about everything we need. It also says made for Google inside. So looks like it's just got some straps on the back. And then we've got a couple different things saying that it was made from recycled plastic bottles. So let's set this aside and take a look at the Pixelbook itself. So here is the Pixelbook Go itself. And I don't think there's anything else in this package at all. So let me set this down. And so we have the Pixelbook Go, and these come in at $649 to $1399, depending on which model you get. They come with a Core M3 all the way up to an i7. So I think this is the i5. Let's take a look here. Here you can see it says 8th gen Intel Core i5 processor, 8 gigs of RAM, 120 gigabytes of storage, full HD display. Now you can actually get this display in up to 4K, but you have to have the i7 variant in order to do that. Now let's go ahead and open this up. So we'll take the wrapper off here. And around the box, it's really nice. It's pretty thin too. And this should be made out of magnesium, but let's open the box. And let's see what we've got inside. So this is the just black variant. You can also get it in not pink. Let's take this out here. It's pretty thin. I'll set it aside just for a moment. And let's see what we've got. So we've got a let's get started. Open your Pixelbook Go to turn it on. We've got some Pixelbook stickers and then a little warranty card. Set those aside. We've got a USB-C to USB-C plug, and it looks like this one's really nice and long, so that's good if we need to extend it to a wall that's a ways away. And then we've got a Pixelbook charging block. Let me open this up here. And the adapter is really nice. It's just a square block, and it says it outputs 3 amps. I don't know if you're going to be able to read that, but it outputs 3 amps. So on the back, there's nothing, but on the bottom is where the actual USB-C plug goes. So that's pretty interesting. Let me set this aside. Now let's go ahead and take the wrapper off. And this is that new bottom that they have. This is all magnesium with a coating on it. So you'll see it looks pretty interesting, but it is a magnesium coating. Now along the outside edge, we have a USB-C port on the right side. And then we have a USB-C port and a headphone jack on the left side. Looks like we also have a little status light there as well. And then let's go ahead and open it up. So we've got a little cover here. Now this display is 1080p, and I didn't expect that to wake up so quickly, but there it goes. It says welcome. Now this one does have a 1080p display. It's 1920 by 1080 with 166 pixels per inch. Now it does have dual front firing speakers. And like I said, it is a Core i5 with 8 gigs of RAM. And then we have these speakers, a nice keyboard, a larger trackpad, and a magnesium frame. So let's go ahead and set it up. And let me select my network here. Optionally, we can send information to Google to help make this a better OS. We'll click accept and continue. Then it says checking for updates. Now it's updating, and this is one of the best things about Chrome OS. Kind of just does everything quickly in the background. It says about 3 minutes left. Once it's done, we'll be good to go. And this is a touch screen, which is really nice. And this also has a couple different microphone arrays here, as well as a front-facing camera that does 1080p, so you can use it for video. This comes in at 2.3 pounds or 1,061 grams, and the i7 model is slightly heavier. This should be pretty good to get at least 10 to 12 hours of battery as well. Now with that charger, you do get fast charging, 2 hours and 20 minutes to fully charge this device, and it has Wi-Fi 802.11 A, B, G, N, and AC. It also has 2x2 MIMO with dual band 2.4 and 5 gigahertz. It also uses Bluetooth 4.2. So that's everything as far as the specs. It feels really good. I like this coating on it. On the back here, this is just very unique. I think it's very, very nice. So now it's updating. It's saying touchpad firmware updating. So that's kind of interesting. We'll wait for that to finish. Now we'll sign into the Chromebook. Now I'm signed in and we'll wait for the next step. And just typing on this to sign in, this is a really nice keyboard. It's one of the nicest I've typed on in a while. Now, as you can see, the keys actually have decent travel here and it's just really nice. So now it's asking me if I want to sync Chrome, or it's telling me about that. I'll hit accept and continue. You have to agree to the Google Play terms of service. Then it's asking you if you want to back up your drive automatically. So we'll hit accept, and then you can install apps from your other devices. So anything you use, anything from tasks to Spotify, you can use, and that'll be really nice. I'll just use Spotify for now, Google Podcasts, and we'll hit install and continue. It says we'll install these two apps for you. We'll continue setup and then access your assistant with voice match. I'll agree. It says loading. It already recognizes my voice. And it says your assistant is ready. We'll hit done. And we have an assistant button here as well. Now it says connect your phone. Your Chromebook and Android phone will work better together. Connect them so you can text from your computer and share your internet connection and unlock them. So we have a couple options here. We can connect the different phones. I'll pick the Pixel 4 XL. Accept and continue. And now we're in. So it says, howdy, Aaron. Take a tour. And it's saying smart lock is turned on. Next time your phone will unlock your Chromebook, you can turn off smart lock in the settings. So we'll click take a tour. We can dim the screen or brighten the screen here. It says get to your apps fast down here. Check your status up here. We'll hit finish for now. So this has all of the Chrome applications I'm familiar with. So if I hit this button here, we have search your device or search the web. We can search, we can just type zollotech. And you'll see it pulls up the browser and it's Chrome. So it's really fast, very nice. And I think I'll enjoy using this. And it looks like it's going to be a pretty interesting experience. I haven't used a Chromebook in a long, long time. So here is my Pixel review, and we can go up to 4K in the settings, which is nice, even though it's a 1080p display. It's not really worth doing that, but it looks really nice. Let me see if we can just scroll to scrub through. That's pretty nice. Let's see if we can go to the photo section here in this video, see what the speakers sound like. They do get a little bit tinny at the top end, but overall they're pretty good, especially for a small laptop. I'm not sure how they compare with other high-end laptops and things, but this should be a pretty interesting device to use over the next week or so as I review it. That's it for the Pixelbook Go. Now, if there's something specific you want to know about it in maybe a future review or comparison, let me know in the comments below. I haven't used a Pixelbook before. I've played around with them. I've used Chromebooks, but never a Pixelbook. And this feels like a semi-premium experience. I do like the bottom of this, and I really like that keyboard so far. But let me know if there's anything specifically that you can't find anywhere else, and I'll be happy to answer that either in a video or in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.